Hello, wonderful family. Another glorious day and another beautiful opportunity to share the word again. Today I go back to a favorite of mine, and that's the story of the centurion in the book of Matthew. I'll be reading from Matthew chapter 8, from verses 5. Hallelujah. Join me. I'm reading from the Amplified Version. As Jesus went into Capernaum, a centurion came up to him, begging him and saying, "Lord, my servant boy is lying at the house, paralyzed and distressed with intense pains." And Jesus said to him, "I will come and restore him." Notice that there was nobody that Jesus said, "It's not my will to restore. I want to restore." Jesus always ended up saying, I will, it's my will. I will come and restore." Whatever was asked of Jesus in that context with respect to health, he always obliged at the end of the day. Now, when he says begging him in verse 5, it's actually saying that he implored him, he prayed. He prayed him. The word pray is to ask. Hallelujah. Verse 8, "But the centurion replied to him, 'Lord,'" sorry, I just a thought came to me. His intention was to get Jesus to heal his boy. He came, he presented his matter. And Jesus said, "I will come and heal him. I will come and restore him." Now, traditionally, up until this time, nobody in Israel had asked for Jesus to come and for Jesus to heal anybody without requesting Jesus' physical presence there. So Jesus answered this chap in like manner, "I will come and restore him." But the centurion replied to him, "Lord, I am not worthy or fit to have you come under my roof, but only speak the word, and my servant boy will be cured." I want you to pay particular attention to that word. He says, "But only speak the word." What is written there is, in the original is, "But only speak the logos, and my servant boy will be cured." What is the logos? To all intents and purposes, the logos, the Bible is the logos. So if one speaks the logos, if one speaks the word in written in that word, you will get the miraculous. He says, "But only speak the word, and my servant boy will be cured. For I also am a man subject to authority, with soldiers subject to me. And I say to one, 'Go,' and he goes, and to another, 'Come,' and he comes, and to my slave, 'Do this,' and he does it." Hallelujah. In essence, he was laying the foundation or telling how in the physical realm authority works. In essence, he was saying that because I am under authority, I'm in a system that recognizes authority. Those above me, I am obedient to. And those beneath me or below me, because we're in that system, they are obligated to obey me. As long as I maintain my position in that system, my cadre in that system, by being subject to those above me, obeying their commands, those beneath me must obey my commands. And that I am looking at this and to you, recognizing that you also belong to a system where there is ranking, and recognizing that you are the king in this system. So because you are in this kind of a system where there is cadre, in cadre, things get done by commands. So my superiors command me, I carry out their commands. I give commands or pronouncements, and those beneath me carry out my commands. It crumbles if those above me give commands and I do not carry out their commands. I do not expect that I would issue commands or decrees and those beneath me will carry them out, because I have already negated that system of Kedar. I recognize this in you as the king. Don't come to my house. Exercise this system of authority embedded in Kedars and give decrees. I know when you make a pronouncement, it will be carried out. In essence, he was saying a whole lot of things. He was recognizing that Jesus, as he was here on earth, whether we care to believe it or not, was subject to his Father. So in obedience, he came down. He was subject to his Father. So he did the will of his Father. So when he made pronouncements, everything will do his will or do his bidding. Everything beneath him will do that in this system, in this Kedar. So he was recognizing that in the spirit realm, there is order and ranking, rank and file. So Jesus has, or Jesus was subject to his Father. And so everything beneath him is subject, or below him in rank and file is subject to his command. So he only needs to make a pronouncement. But look at it, recognize it. He says that the reason this works for him is because he obeys that which is above. So for you, if you want to give orders in this rank and filing, obey, respect, maintain this order that you obey and respect that which is above you. If Jehovah says something, you are subject to it, you do it. So that when you say something, those subject to you, those beneath you, will do it. When I say those, I'm not talking of human beings now, I'm talking of spirit beings. Beneath you will do it. When Jesus heard him, he marveled and said to those who followed him, who adhered steadfastly to him, conforming to his example in living and if need be in dying also, I tell you truly, I have not found so much faith as this with anyone, even in Israel. I tell you, many will come from east and west and will sit at table with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob in the kingdom of heaven, while the sons and heirs of the kingdom will be driven out into the darkness outside, where there will be weeping and grinding of teeth. Then to the centurion, Jesus said, go. He was now making that pronouncement. Go. It shall be done for you as you have believed. And the servant boy was restored to health at that very moment. So Jesus was making certain things clear here now. Say, what you believe is what you will get. And because you have believed the core, the best, the highest form of revelation with respect to authority, you will get it. Go. And for it shall be done for you as you have believed. And the servant boy was restored to health at that very moment. Respect and be subject to that Kedar, so that Kedar also works for you when you make your pronouncements. If you abuse it, you refuse to be subject to it, you cannot use it. You cannot make those pronouncements. Say, go. And they will go. Or those subject to you will go. It's not possible. He said it here. Say, I'm a man now, reading like from the King James, I'm a man under authority. I am subject to authority. And I have those that are subject to me. This is a system. And for me to fit into that, it basically was telling them, or telling, saying, reiterating what happens in the military. I receive orders, I carry out those orders from those superior to me. I give orders to those who I am superior to in the same military. The minute or the instant that I start disobeying orders, Those under me will not carry out my orders. I will be banged in the brig. You get? God bless you guys. I love you. Hallelujah.